The challenges put on our public systems is extraordinary. Know this, and that is Texas already long ago sued the federal government about having to incur the cost of that education program.
Yes.
It's a case called Plyler versus Doe. And the Supreme Court ruled against us on the issue about denying, or let's say Texas having to bear that burden. I think we will resurrect that case and challenge this issue again, because the expenses are extraordinary and the times are different than when Plyler versus Doe was issued many decades ago.
Very, very basically, Plyler versus Doe means if your kid is in the district, the kid gets a free public a public education. And of course, that burden goes to wherever that district is.
Okay, so that, of course, is Greg Abbott, governor of Texas, speaking to, as my producer points out, some guy wearing silk pajamas, I guess. I don't know. I wear the pineapple shirt, so I guess I can't throw stones. But what they're talking about there, if it's not easy to follow, is they're talking about a decision, Plyler versus Doe, way back in 1982. Now, the fact that it's way back doesn't mean that they won't try to overturn it again. Precedent doesn't matter. It doesn't matter how long it's been there. That Supreme Court decision required states to offer free public education to all children, including those of undocumented immigrants. And so that is what he's saying we're going to challenge, Greg Abbott. They want to knock that out, ostensibly, immediately. What he's admitting to is so that we don't have to offer an education to children of undocumented immigrants. So that is by itself awful, hateful, cruel, needless. But do you think, Viviana, that that's where they would end? This movement, which has despised public education for longer than we've been alive, which frequently during presidential campaigns will talk about like literally destroying the Department of Education, you think that they won't eventually dabble at the possibility of getting rid of public education entirely in Texas? I find that to be incredibly plausible. But we can start where we're already at, which is they want to block the children of undocumented immigrants from having access to an education.
Yeah, completely unconstitutional. It's been tried by many, many states, Texas being one, California being one with Prop 182. And what happens is when you start to require proof of citizenship for attending public school or getting emergency healthcare, it really gets into tricky, unconstitutional waters, because you start, who's getting targeted? Who's getting asked for their papers? It's really ugly for the same people who are arguing on behalf of the unborn to say things like this about school age children.
Yeah.
That they shouldn't have access to learn how to read or write, and calling it a burden and using words like illegal immigrants as well, as not instead of undocumented, because this language is important as well. These are children. And you know, they can try all they want. I really hope that this Supreme Court doesn't back away completely on human rights across, I mean, really anything is possible at this point, because they don't seem to have any respect for precedent. But this is something that many, many states have tried to do. Texas has been really big on it. And you're right on the attack of public education. With the influx of charter schools and private schools and voucher programs, the budgets for public educations have increasingly been shrunk. The pandemic had a real negative effect on public education and the education of children across the country. So we're in a really tough predicament right now in regards to public education. You would think the first lady, being an educator herself, she claimed she was gonna get her elbows dirty and whatever, greased elbows, I don't know what the saying is. She was supposed to get in there and start really helping. Has she?
Yeah, but no, she hasn't.
Elbow grease. She's supposed to put her elbow grease in it, right? I haven't even seen her. Where is she? What is she doing?
I don't know. She was at the White House correspondent. That's really the only time I've seen her. But anyway, and look, on the other side, again, so this is already extreme enough. If you think that I'm crazy, that they won't go further, think about the pressure that Greg Abbott is going to be feeling with the right wing, who spent years now going to school board meetings, trying to destroy the individual lives of educators. They think they're all groomers. You don't think that they're going to try to kill public education entirely? They want us uneducated.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.